believe the traditional media in this country reports fake news, because they do. And at this point, it's pretty much to be expected, but we can promise you we're always going to fight back against their extreme bias and their lying. All right, joining us now is Fox News investigative reporter Sarah Carter, Fox News legal analyst Greg Jarrett. All right, Sarah, let's go into your piece today. I left out some of the details. I'll let you fill in the gaps.
Well, congressional investigators have discovered, you know, once again, another trove of text messages between Lisa Page and Peter Strzok, the two FBI agents. And what these text messages in particular reveal, that the FBI may have improperly coordinated with Department of Justice officials to try to expedite FISA applications on Carter Page. And what was interesting about this, Sean, is that if you look at it, they talk about David Loftman. Now, he hasn't come up quite frequently at all in the media. David Loftman was a DOJ prosecutor. Strzok is talking to Lisa Page about David Loftman. He was in charge of the Hillary Clinton investigation on the DOJ side. He was a very senior level official in charge of national security as well as Russia. And Peter Strzok tells Lisa Page, basically, look, you know, I'm upset with Loftman. Loftman's trying to explain why these things aren't moving fast enough in the Eastern District of Virginia, probably referencing that, you know, the area where the subpoenas had been issued by Mueller, and the FISA application isn't moving fast enough. So it kind of shows this buildup. They also noticed that that White House logs actually correlated with some of these text messages. So as they were discussing this back and forth, they bring up another guy from the DOJ, Matthew Axelrod. He's a DOJ prosecutor who's involved in the case. They talk about him. They talk about the frustration. They talk about Andy McCabe maybe coming under fire or by some of these folks at the DOJ for the supposed information that was in the application. And then they say, 2 days later, after these text messages are exchanged, Matthew Axelrod actually goes to the White House and signs the visitor's log and actually visits President Trump. And I think what we're looking at here is little pieces of the puzzle. How much did people in the White House know? Did the president know about this investigation himself? What we do know now is, based on information that came out last week, is that very senior level members in the FBI, the CIA, and in the White House were well aware of this investigation early on and may have coordinated.
Greg.
Well, I think the big news really comes out of the court documents. Thanks to Manafort's attorneys, we now know that Rosenstein admits that he wrote intentionally a vague order in his appointment of Mueller, trying to mislead the American public.
Intentionally vague to mislead.
Right, to mislead and disguise what it is they were doing. He didn't realize or anticipate that Manafort's lawyer is going to say, wait a minute, this violates the special counsel law. And they go to a judge and make a motion to dismiss. So now we find out that in addition to writing this vague memo, they secretly, Rosenstein secretly writes a specific memo and hides it from the American public, authorizing the Manafort investigation.
Is he conflicted because he reauthorized the FISA warrant against the Trump campaign associate and appointed Mueller?
Both, yes. And the other interesting thing is, look at the date on his secret memo authorizing the Manafort investigation. It's a full week after Mueller ordered the raid on Manafort's home in the pre-dawn hours.
Sounds like a CYA to me.
Exactly.
Counselor.
It's exactly what they did. They realized after the fact, oh, wait a minute, we may have violated the special counsel law.
Did they violate it?
Oh, absolutely. The law says you have to specifically identify facts, and because it's a criminal investigation, identify
and
a
also,
crime.
And the Attorney General Sessions didn't recuse himself from this part.
No.
Wouldn't that be something that he had to involve himself in?
Well, he recused himself from anything related to a Russian meddling in the campaign.
All right. Unbelievable. Real quick, Sarah, I'd hear you.
Yeah, well, I just want to say, but who holds them accountable? Who will hold Rosenstein accountable, Mueller accountable? Those are the questions we really need to ask now.
That's why you need a second special counsel to investigate the investigators.
You don't like, Jonathan Turley said this may end up working faster for Trump by appointing this Utah prosecutor.
It could, because he is, as Turley points out, armed with the ability to issue warrants and subpoenas
so
and interview
faster,
witnesses.
Rather than a special counsel,
exactly.
Long investigation.
Exactly.
All right. Thank you both. Appreciate it. When we come back, Dan Bongino, Sebastian Gorka.